Hello and welcome everyone, live from Studio 7 at CNN Center. I'm Valerie Kananga.
And I'm Darya Surya.
Coming up here on CNN today. The US Coast Guard revises guidance to ensure cybersecurity is given more importance.
Port facilities are unprotected to cyber threats according to the Conference Head.
EFL to secure release of four Pinoys kidnapped in Gulf of Geneva.
Nigeria, guidance on contacting government security forces.
Now, news in brief. The US Coast Guard revises guidance to ensure cybersecurity is given more importance. The United States is placing increasing importance on cyber as an element of seaworthiness. In its upgraded guidance to marine inspectors and port safe control officers on assessing cyber risk management in commercial vessels, the US Coast Guard has expanded the range of vessels that must comply. Now, all US flagged vessels that require a vessel security plan as defined, it must ensure corporate cyber.
They explained how the port facilities remain unprotected to and are unprepared for cyber threats. Cyber attacks on logistic hubs would devastate the supply chain network with tremendous financial damage, said Mr. Moran.
DFL to secure release of four Pinoys kidnapped in Gulf of Geneva. The Department of Foreign Affairs Manila is working to secure the safe release of four Filipino seafarers who were abducted by pirates of the Gulf of Geneva. Families have been informed the efforts are underway to secure the crew members, said Chris, the DFS said in a statement on Thursday. Initial reports said the vessel had 21 on board, which includes Romanians and Filipinos.
Nigeria, guidance for contacting government security forces. On 18th of February 2021, Risk Intelligence published a set of guidelines concerning the use of privately contracted government security forces in Nigeria. The publication was released following the recent development on the disbanding of the secure anchorage area and to provide clarity in the use of the armed security in Nigeria waters. The use of armed guard on merchant ships has been expressly prohibited by the Nigerian Navy's Chief of Naval Staff since 6 June 2016.
Maritime crime creates potential hazards throughout the world. Three notable subjects of maritime crime are armed robbery at sea, occurring within the nation's territorial sea, and piracy, which take place in waters beyond the territorial sea. There have been recent concentrations of armed robbery and piracy in the waters of Southeast Asia, the Horn of Africa, the Caribbean and the Gulf of Guinea. Even though terrorism, illegal migration at sea, cybersecurity breaches, illegal, unreported and unregulated fishing are also main hazards throughout the world.
Cyber attacks are increasingly becoming a major threat to vessels, shipping and offshore companies. Ever more extensive and complex information technology allows attackers to exploit vulnerabilities. Modern monitoring systems are increasingly being used in the maritime industry to help improve vessel efficiency. Information exchanges between onshore office and vessels are now becoming part of the cyber war playing.
Roll it.
From those who
know
absolutely percent about cybersecurity breaches, the maritime cybersecurity landscape is consuming place. On the one hand, you have commercial providers suggesting the risk of everything from a hostile attack on ship system, which allows the vessel to be remotely controlled by the pirates and direct it to a port of their choice, or causing catastrophic navigation errors, phishing attack or ransomware on the master's PC. While on the other, you have sensible people who point out that this notion is nonsense due to the number of fail safes and manual overrides and control in place. When we find out about the maritime law regulation according to the cybersecurity breaches, it was updated nearly 2020 by international maritime organizations.
It's to create massive damage. Without the right cybersecurity barriers, attackers could tap into the information flow and cause issues with maneuverability or cargo containment, or target valuable cargo and coordinate piracy. Such scenarios can negatively impact business performance and reputation. Personnel and crew must be aware of these risks in order to help keep the ship, its systems, and the crew secure.
Cyber attacks are real threats to the maritime industry.
more and more security breaches are reported. The safety of the business operation is consistently at a risk. Companies are losing millions of dollars. Cruise passengers and the environment are being put in danger. Cybersecurity of the maritime industry, what you need to know. Digitalization and connectivity open up new opportunities. However, they also interrupt the unknown risk. Cyber resilience indicates the strength of your information technology or operation systems. It is needed to enable companies to safely reap the benefit of the interconnected, automated and digital ships and offshore operations. On the global level, we have the IMO resolutions and the MSC 428.98. This one confirms all shipping companies need to have cybersecurity in their management system. Flag states are encouraged to check in this in the first annual audit after the 1st January 2021. So now cybersecurity is the regular requirement for the maritime industry. There are basically two kinds of cyber threats, internal and uninternal. Examples of internal cyber attacks are hacking or malicious software, unknown as malware. Those may be performed by malicious hackers or disgruntled employees. Uninternal cyber incidents can be the results of operator misuse of design flaws. Those include poor software maintenance, software bugs due to the lack of testing or inappropriate user permissions. There is also risk related to uninternal human mistakes. Effective cyber risk management should consider all relevant threats.
My name is Captain Harold. I am the captain of the Blackbird ship. We were near the Caribbean island. Suddenly our system got stuck. None of our radar and sensors worked. All our relationships broke down. We could not communicate anything. Our ship had a large load of containers. At first we thought it was a problem with the engine or the system. Finally, I found out about it. That's when I found out we had a cyber attack. We could not navigate our ship. We could not imagine what to do. But we survived because talented of the engineer on our ship. This is the very first time something like this has happened to us. It was a very awful moment memory. My first officer will further describe about that context.
Once the malicious software has infected one computer, it may quickly spread to other connected to the same network. Think before you click, research the facts behind emails and their attachments. Make sure external drivers and USBs are clean. Be aware when third parties access your system or data. Protect your password. Never connect the personal items to the ship critical system. And never use external Wi-Fi for the company emails or downloads unless the network is protected and safe. So hope the maritime industry will follow the best practices for the cybersecurity awareness.
So the maritime cyber risk refers to a measure of extent to which a technology asset could be threatened by a potential circumstance or event which may result in shipping-related operational safety or security failures. When it comes to cyber risk management, it means the process of identifying, analyzing, assessing and communicating a cyber-related risk and accepting, avoiding, transferring or mitigating it to an acceptable level considering costs and benefits of action taken to stakeholders.
As the president of IMO, IMO has issued MSC guidelines on maritime cyber risk management. The guidelines approved high-level recommendations on maritime cyber risk management to safeguard shipping from current and emerging cyber threats and include functional elements that support effective cyber risk management. The recommendation can be incorporated into existing risk management process and are complementary to the safety and security management practices already established by IMO. The Maritime Safety Committee at its 98th session in June 2017 also adopted maritime cyber risk management in safety management system. The regulation encouraged administration to ensure that cyber risks are addressed in its existing safety management system. No later than the first annual verification of the company's document of computation after 1st January 2021.
Shipping today is one of the cleanest and safest forms of transport. Every day, the global fleet carries billions of tons of cargo across millions of miles of ocean without accidents or incidents. Since the 1950s, the global rules covering safety at sea have been made by the International Maritime Organization, IMO.
When we talk about cybersecurity, it is not an afterthought. If you will be attached, but when? In order to deal with that, you should have a risk management approach on it. And this is what the IMO is introducing. IMO is an organization that takes care of safety, environmental concerns, legal matters, technical cooperation, maritime security, and works toward efficiency of shipping in international waters. It has over 174 member states and 3 associated members, and assembly that govern 5 committees. Namely, the Maritime Safety Committee, the Maritime Environmental Protection Committee, the Legal Committee, the Technical Cooperation Committee, and the Facilitation Committee.
Every day, the global fleet carries billions of tons of cargo across millions of miles of ocean without accidents or incidents. So for that, you need rules and regulations in order to protect the merchant ships from the threats and the risk we mentioned. The global rules that cover safety in the sea are mostly introduced by International Maritime Organization and more specifically by the Maritime Safety Committee of IMO. Convention on International Regulations for Preventing Collisions at Sea, CORREG. By this regulation, it provides barriers to the cyber hackers, ensuring merchant ships are protected. And also, there's a special chapter in SOLAS, Safety Life at Sea, detailing requirements for radar, GPS, depth sounders, electronic charts, and many others. It regularly updated and amended by Maritime Safety Committee to ensure ships continuously benefits from the latest technology. Because the modern systems are open to environment and hackers can easily access the systems. Modern monitoring systems are used to increase vessel efficient information exchanges between onshore office and shoreside requested information, and is transmitted via remote satellite connections through which vessels critical information is exchanged. Data streams flow to and from the ships through industrial automation control systems, and there are multiple sensors that are connected to that. And also parallel networks used such as Wi-Fi and other crypto-facing networks, so that more software-dependent systems run very important data streams which are needed for safe operations. So through the above chapter, SOLAS, we ensure that merchant ships are protected through those guidelines. And there's a wider variety of maritime information streams offers more lucrative options or opportunities to create massive damage without right cybersecurity barriers. Attackers can tap into information flow and cause issues with maneuverability or cargo containment, or target valuable cargo or coordinate tires. And such scenarios can negatively impact. So, MSC FAL 1 Circular 3 ensures merchant ships are adapted to effective cybersecurity protection methodology in order to protect from the cybersecurity breaches. And also, Resolution MSC 428 helps in coming up with new administration methods, guidelines, and also International Maritime Code in order to protect merchant ships. And all the shipping companies should have or should have their own maritime cybersecurity management systems as for the regulation, so that the merchant ships are secured from the cybersecurity breaches in the marine.
As we mentioned over the presentation, we can identify cyber attack as a really hostile threat to the merchant ship all over the world. Even though we can to arrange cyber security management and safety management system for that. Therefore, we can build up cyber risk management approach. We have identified threat, identify vulnerabilities, access risk, export, develop protection and detection measures. establishing contingency plan respond to the recover from cybersecurity incident. Apply those factors, we can minimize this dangerous hazardous situation and protect the mercantile ship.